the state of hip hop, it's changed. It's changed a lot in the last 20 years, you know, since I started trying to be that rap guy. I feel like there's a lot of really creative things going on. People who are no longer boxed in to the hip hop identity. You know, when I was a kid growing up, you were only allowed to rap like about four things. You were allowed to rap about how good of a rapper you were. You were allowed to have a reggae song. You were allowed to rap about how good of a lover you were. And you get one song for that on your album. You can't do like I do where there's like 12 songs. Atmosphere is a rap group from Minneapolis. I grew up in South Minneapolis, and Anthony Davis, who makes the beats, grew up all over the place. He was an Army brat. We met in 1994. I had already previously been walking down the road of trying to be a rap star, and he was making music for other rappers. And that's kind of how we met. We met through a mutual friend. And when he introduced us, we clicked. Not so much because of personalities or anything, but I think mostly based on work ethic. We both preferred to make songs, make music, than to party or hang out. And I don't know that we would have ever became friends had we not started to make tons and tons of music together. Hides the eyes beneath the bill of the cap. Watch amongst them flies that hover over the map. He lies, but only when there's a reason. Measures life by the tragedy, the comedy, the season. In the first few years of knowing each other, we probably made about 1,500 songs. We really didn't have a very good formula for making music. The only bond that was there was that we both would stay up all night and work together. And, you know, I still have all of these songs. And they're not that good, but what they are is they're very hungry. Doesn't take much, and that's messed up. Because these people do a lot of simple shit to impress us. While everyone was trying to outdo the last man, I was just a ghost trying to catch some of his Pac-Man. It's a couple of guys trying to learn how to write a song, trying to learn how to write a chorus, trying to learn how to write a verse, trying to learn how to communicate. And that was slowly how the friendship formed. You know, now it's a whole different thing because we became friends through that. And so that was what it took for us to finally learn how to make music. Ain't no way to explain how painful the hangover was today. In front of the toilet on my hands and knees, trying to breathe in between the dry heaves. My baby made me some coffee, but if I drink it, it's probably coming right back at me. Couple of Advil, relax and chill. I'm at a standstill with how bad I feel. Tonight, we're at First Ave. We're gonna play the fifth and final show of the 2014 Welcome to Minnesota Tour. It's gonna be really fun though. It's big cluster funk of rap. Who cares what Jane says? She always say the same. Rather kill the radio, listen to the rain hit. Little sister needs seclusion, somehow she'll discover it. Through the pop music, got used to the feeling of falling. But you'll never see it following, bouncing back and forth. From the healing to the hollering, riding the outer ring of your own private Saturn. Thoughts scatter all across the gray matter. Little baby dog doesn't know what to say to y'all. Patience is short, course the bride's way too tall. Break it all, smash the past like it was made of glass. Ain't no other way to make it last. The mid-90s, like 96, if you didn't have a record label supporting you, nobody knew who you were. And so the internet showed us that there were hundreds and hundreds of rappers like us who didn't have the support of a record label or even an audience or a fan base, but we were getting to know who each other were just as artists. And so it was almost like artists were becoming fans of other artists, and we were discovering each other like that. And then, you know, in time you would maybe travel and meet some of these guys who you'd heard come through on the tape trading circuit. Then, you know, in time, we helped develop and start a record label called Rhymesayers. It's the foremost importance. There is none like unto the brother out this mother. Regardless of stop all the nonsense. You see me lounging, call Rhymesayers office. I've officially lost it. Back to the wall, crush it. Laugh at them all, hush them. Try to find the beauty in your face. Yeah, something more than a song. Hate it. Oh, come on, dust them. Try to find the beauty in the bass line. You're so bitter. You're cold as a river in the winter. This one is to recognize you. Your jealousy needs an anthem too. I wear many hats at Rhymesayers, but the only hat that I always wear is the artist hat. When it comes to a lot of the business decisions that go on at Rhymesayers, I tend to stay out of them. There's a conflict of interest there because I am an artist. my relationship with the label has always been very honest and upfront. That puts everybody else there in a position of being able to be that honest back with me, which I think is healthy because I don't have yes men. Like, people will tell me when they don't like what the record I'm turning in, but they still kind of give me the room to do whatever it is that I'm choosing to do. Even when people don't necessarily understand what I'm doing, they kind of go, well, let's just see what happens. I'm shook, I know. Pushed when I should have pulled, took it all back if I could. I put that on my soul. I can make a top notch good listener. You can block off a little time out to give it here. Since we went our separate paths, I've hit a couple of snags that remind me of the past. I can't front, y'all, I'm having a blast. But damned if I ain't afraid of how long it's gonna last. When I'm writing, when I'm in my groove, I'm by myself. I usually pick a place. And I stick with that place for at least a year. Like right now, I'm in my basement. And that's the only place I write right now. You know, 2 years ago, it was on my back porch. It was the only place I wrote. But I pick a place, I get comfortable, and then I spend a year or two in that position writing. And I do it alone. You know, I only write to the music that Anthony provides me with. Or if I'm trying to work on a collaboration or something, I write to the music. I don't write to silence. I don't free write. And I drink a lot of coffee. It trips me out how you pick up all my traits, from the way that you spit to the fists that you make. I watch the way you try to keep your mama happy. Daddy learned that from you. You're supposed to learn that from daddy. I can't teach much when it comes to women. I drive safe and slow, but don't know nothing about the engine. You're doing good, little man. That's all I really meant. I love you. You're my best friend. Thanks for listening. The evolution of the music, fatherhood is definitely played a part. Every part of me has played a part, though. I can look at my own personal history with my music and see how every time I've released a record, it's kind of been a snapshot of where my life is at that time. Everything from being a courier to opening a record store to being a father to, you know, getting married, all of these things have all shaped what the songs are about. My writing crutch is just me. Like, I just go to what I'm thinking about, what I'm dealing with, the things that I guess I've lived with and touched as just a person who grew up in South Minneapolis. Those are the things that I'll probably always write about. I wanted to make a song about where I'm from, you know. Big up my hometown, territory, my lake. I couldn't figure out what to brag about. Prince lives here, we got 10,000 lakes. But wait, the women are beautiful, to me they are. We not infested with pretentious movie stars. Then it hit me, Minnesota is dope. If only simply, not what we got, but what we don't. I get to travel a lot, and there is no other place in this world that I've been to that, pound for pound, when you look at what our population is, we have more people living off of rap music than any other city in this world. And, you know, granted, sure, your New York and your LA compete and even do better, and Atlanta do better, but when you look at the sizes of those communities, and you also look at the fact that the majority of those artists that are living off of it are also major label artists. But when you just talk about independent music, Minneapolis, St. Paul, there's no other place like this. And I just hope that we don't ever take that for granted. As long as I can hit those notes, I'ma stand top this box of soap. I felt the track slip, but damn, full breaks. We half dead, but already got a full plate. As long as we can hit those notes. Twin Cities, thank you very much. We're called Atmosphere, we're from Minneapolis.